as long as there is a WWE, the name Undertaker has meaning. Well, get ready and hold on to your seats, because the Undertaker's response to my challenge at WrestleMania is nothing. And that is the biggest mistake the Undertaker has ever made. I said it last week and I meant it. I do not mind going to WrestleMania as a fan. I would love to go to WrestleMania as the Undertaker's opponent. But for that dude to not be able to get off his ass and give me a yes or no, that is damn disrespectful. It is disrespectful to me. But more importantly, it is disrespectful to each and every one of you. You see, folks, without you guys, there's no streak. There is no rest in peace, and there damn sure ain't no Undertaker. So, Mr. Undertaker, after all of these people have given you everything they have, you can't find it to give them a yes or a no? Dude, if you're retired, say no and be retired, and everybody in here understands. But if you're not retired, damn it, man, say yes and give the world what they want to see. But what do you do? You sit there and drown in your own insecurity. You are not the God that they made you. You are the man you've allowed yourself to become. And that man, Undertaker, is a coward. The Undertaker is a coward. You hear that? There it is. The exact moment you let everybody down who ever believed in you. Undertaker, you are not a god, and right now you should barely be able to call yourself a man.
Comes the sign Cena was looking for.
The sign is Kane, the big red monster, the brother of the Undertaker.
Kane, is it yes or is it no?
Chokeslam to Cena.
But was that a yes? Or was that a no?
Or was it Kane stepping up to face John Cena at WrestleMania?